Here's one of comedy's brightest stars at the moment with a massive following on YouTube and social media. But as he explains in his stand-up show, Kanan Gill's parents aren't as tech-savvy as he is.
I hope you're having a good day also, because I'm having a slightly weird day. Because earlier today, my dad called me to tell me that he has sent me a WhatsApp. He's like, "Hi, Kanan, I have sent you a photo. Please look at the photo and call me back. Regards, Colonel Charanjit." And this would have been fine, but the photo that he sent me is of my mother, who is holding an iPad, on which is the actual photo that they wanted to send.
I'm so cool.
Please welcome comedian Kanan Gill to Studio 10. Nice to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, before you got into stand-up, you had a real proper job that your parents were very proud of you for having. You were a software engineer.
Yes, that's true.
How did that conversation go down when you said, "Hey, Mum, Dad, by the way, I'm trying my hand at stand-up comedy"?
Well, when you're leaving, like, a super stable, well-paying job to do, you know, just a pretty much volatile job where the money's not for sure and... Indian parents are pretty conservative sometimes. So what I did was I lied to them. And that's worked out really well. And now they're finding out I do comedy professionally. Now you know.
Mom,
oh, I actually told them that I'd probably get another job at some point. Just don't wait up. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Bless.
Were you always funny as a kid? Did you have this in you? Because, you know, Dilruk, that beautiful man as well, who is a great comedian here in Australia, he was an accountant and was doing stand-up in his spare time. And then he just went, you know what, this is not giving me joy to be an accountant, and followed his dream and won Best Newcomer at the Logies, a huge award show here in Australia.
Oh, brilliant.
Was it hard to take that leap of faith?
To do stand-up?
Yeah.
No, I just really hated writing software.
Yeah.
We were writing software for the American government. Oh, we were making a product we're trying to sell them, and I quit, and they didn't buy it, and the company shut down. In that order.
It was meant to be.
Yeah. I would be pretty upset if I was still there, I think.
Yeah. So never tempted to go back.
Never tempted to go back.
Now, you only just got your driver's license a couple of years ago, and you said you went to a hardcore driving school.
Yeah.
What makes our driving school hardcore?
Our driving school had a learner's license mock exam test to prepare you for what would be the learner's license test. And the questions were prepared in a different language and translated into English badly. So one of the questions was, if a policeman stops you, how should you feel?
So,
the actual question, the options were proud, ashamed, and option C was to correct behavior in the future. No, there was a feeling that starts with the word to. And also, my favorite question was, this is the actual question, you can look it up. It was, there is a cow, how do you cross? And it doesn't mention where you are or where the cow is. Like, there was one when we wrote this question, and it's still there.
Did you answer correctly? What did you do with the cow?
Yeah, you worship it.
You gotta go, Cows rule, right?
Yes, they do.
And
don't get me in trouble, yeah.
You haven't been to Australia before?
This is my first time,
wow. Yeah. For the comedy festival?
Yes.
And so, do you find, have you performed here yet?
Yes, I just did a spot yesterday, it was fantastic.
So, do you mainly perform to Indian audiences? Up until now, have you?
Yeah, I mean, in India, the population is quite Indian.
Sorry, I just realised as I asked that. That's pretty dumb. But no, I guess what I'm saying is the Indian and Australian sense of humour, is it similar?
Yeah, that's what I'm finding when coming here. People in Australia, what I like is they enjoy stranger comedy.
Mm-hmm.
I think people are pretty saturated with comedy, so you can just do something bizarre here.
Yeah.
We're like, thank you for trying something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know a lot of times some comedians may, you know, take the mickey out of the Indian accent.
Yes.
If you were going to take the mickey out of an Australian, how would you do it?
Oh.
Go on.
I would... Okay, so I have...
Go on.
This is like that hardcore driving school. But we're giving you no options.
All right, well, this is what I'm trying to do. If you're ever lonely in Melbourne, you should go outside and say, I have not tried the coffee yet. And a throng of people will descend on you and say, Mike, you got to have the coffee, Mike.
Yay!
Yeah, you can do it.
Mike. I apologise for the accent.
No, it was really good. Now, you've done a Bollywood movie. I'm so impressed with that.
I have.
Do you want to do some more?
I was the romantic lead in a Bollywood movie. This is a true story.
And, so good.
If you have you, that's me. Yeah.
Look at you. Oh,
handsome. Did you whole dance thing too?
I had a little bit of
you dance. Have to do dance.
Oh, they dance.
No. Yeah, they've cut me out of this part.
Yeah. It's the dancing and the song, isn't it? About Hollywood film.
I was so bad at dancing, so they just gave me generic stuff in the background in slow motion.
They photoshopped your face onto a dancer.
Yeah, it's actually it's a stunt professional, and just my head on top. I think I might be better at writing films. I think acting is not my strongest suit. Yeah.
Kanan, my husband's in IT, and he fancies himself a little bit of a comedian. Oh. Have you ever heard of code PEBCAC?
No, I haven't.
Okay, so that's when an absolute ridiculous person who can't work IT calls in and they go, we have a code PEBCAC, and he giggles to himself. Yeah. PEBCAC is acronym for problem exists between chair and computer.
That's hilarious.
As in the person, does it?
Yeah.
Should he go into stand-up?
I think he should.
Yeah, I agree. Kanan Gill is touring Australia, and you can get all the details at frontiercomedy.com. You're a legend. Thanks, Kanan.
Thank you for having me.
Enjoy Australia.